Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum students. Our today's topic is language family. In previous lectures, I have given you a detailed definition and description of language. We also discussed characteristics of language. I hope you remember those lectures. You know that language is a method of human communication consisting of words. The words are used in a structured way and conveyed by speech, writing, or gesture. We move towards our topic, language families. A language family is a group of related languages that develop from a common historic ancestor. The ancestral language is not known directly, but it is possible to discover many of its features by applying the comparative method that can demonstrate the family status of many languages. The six largest language families by language count are Niger-Congo-Austronesian, Sino-Tibetan, Trans-New-Guinea, Indo-European, and Afro-Asiatic. Each of these families has at least 5% of the world's languages. Estimates on the number of living languages vary from 5,000 to 7,000 living human languages. Let's have a look on history. Filippo Sassetti was a traveler and merchant from a long-established Florentine mercantile family. He was born in Florence. He traveled to the Indian subcontinent. In India, he noted that a number of words in Sanskrit seemed related to Italian words. Joseph Justus Scaliger was a French religious leader and scholar. He divided languages of Europe into four types. Sir William Jones. He is generally regarded as father of historical linguistics. He spoke three languages fluently and also knew 28 others. In 1786, he gave a talk to a small group about Sanskrit and some European languages that later became an important work in linguistics. The Sanskrit language, whatever be its antiquity, is of a wonderful structure, more perfect than the Greek, more copious than Latin, and more exquisitely refined than either, yet bearing to both of them a stronger affinity, both in the roots of verbs and in the forms of grammar. Ramsdorff was a Danish linguist and philologist. He wrote several grammars and worked on comparative phonology and morphology. Students, here I have used some terms which might be difficult for you to comprehend. I thought it better to explain for your convenience. Philologist. Philologist is a person who specializes in the study of literary texts and written records. Phonology. Phonology is a branch of linguistics dealing with systems of sounds. Morphology. Morphology is the study of the forms of things. Structure of a family. Language families can be divided into smaller phylogenetic units, which refer to as branches of the family, because the history of language family is often represented as a tree diagram. Phylogenetic relationship refers to the relative times in the past that species shared common ancestors. Dialect continuum. Dialect continuum or dialect area was defined by Bloomfield as a range of dialects spoken across some geographical area that differ only slightly between neighboring areas, but as one travels in any direction, the difference accumulates in such a way that dialects from opposite ends of the continuum are no longer mutually intelligible. For example, Chinese and Arabic. The varieties of Chinese dialect are highly divergent and are comparable to a language family like that of the Romance languages. Language isolate. Isolate is a natural language with no demonstrable genealogical or genetic relationship. Proto-languages. The common ancestor of a language family is seldom known directly, since most languages have a relatively short recorded history. However, it is possible to recover many features of a proto-language by applying the comparative method to reconstructive procedure worked out by 19th century linguist August Schelcher. Dear students, note down the lecture, read it carefully, and then answer these questions. Question number 1. What is a language family? Question number 2. What are the most important language families? Question number 3. What are some of the characteristics of Sanskrit language? Question number 4. Define dialect continuum. Question number 5. What is language isolate? Answers of these questions must be written in your notebooks. That's all for today's lecture. Dear students, push yourself